Absolutely amazing to have you here with us, and congratulations on this film. Can you start by talking a little bit about what it was about this moment in human history, this people, this place, that made you want to bring it to screen in this very vivid and impactful way?
It's a great question. It really was the article that Luke Mogelson wrote in The New Yorker. It was some of the best journalism I've ever read, and it wasn't... I hadn't finished the article before I realized I was desperate to write this story, not only write it, but direct it, if only to show a much larger audience who these people are, how they've been forced to live for the last 3 years, really a minute-by-minute existence, where they can go from gun battle to jokes to cigarettes back to gun battle in a matter of minutes, literally. And I just I thought it was a once in a lifetime opportunity, and to partner with producers like Joe and Anthony, who never flinched when I said we should shoot it in Arabic with an all regional cast from that part of the world who have some connection to this story. Maybe they haven't fought in Mosul or lived it, but they have family. They're from war torn parts. It was just. Yeah, I mean, it's why I want to make movies in the first place.
People around the world are familiar with the events of Mosul, but can you talk a little bit about the specific human story and putting a human face on those global events?
Yeah, start with the SWAT team. I mean, local cops in Mosul, who a lot of these ISIS terrorists... grew up with these guys. They were cops and robbers long before there was an ISIS to join. So a lot of these guys who flocked to ISIS when they invaded were criminals who had been arrested by the cops that made up the SWAT team before the war started. So there was a man I talked to who was an Iraqi Golden Division commando who told me a story about they were in a firefight, and the guy next to him turned as they were reloading and said, "We're shooting at my cousin." He recognized his cousin on the other side of the line. And I just, you know, it made me think of the American Civil War. It made me think of how brutal politics and religion and combat can be. They can quite literally shred families. And that I would love to think that I would have a similar level of courage and bravery were I ever to find myself in a similarly hellish situation. I just wanted to, you know, show people that this exists there and that this idea we have of Iraq is really incomplete unless you know about people like the Nineveh SWAT team.
In terms of politics, people automatically assume that a film about Iraq and about military conflict in general must have some form of political message attached to it, must have a viewpoint on that conflict as a whole.
Yeah.
Can you talk about the extent to which you feel this film does or does not have that?
I really tried to just stay away from the politics of it. I mean, in large part because the politics are pretty cut and dry. It's a group of decent human beings fighting back one of the ugliest, most retrograde groups that I think the world has seen since Nazi Germany. I mean, just a vicious, hateful, sexist, murderous group of people. So I didn't want to delve into the political outside of just the subject matter of war. So I just tried to show how these people have to live their lives and the things they're doing to fight back to get some modicum of peace and prosperity and health and love back into those lives. But no, I didn't elaborate on the politics, which is something for me because I, you know, those are typically the things I like to write and every once in a while throw my two cents in, for better or worse. Yeah.
How much does it mean to you to have two master storytellers like the Russo brothers throwing their support behind this project and producing?
It wouldn't have been possible without them. I mean, truly, I can't think of anybody else who would have made this movie in the way we made it. And the fact that they never needed to be cajoled, they were on board the moment I said, this is how I think we should do it. And I truly not to blow too much smoke, but I truly don't know of another couple, another crew that would have done this way. And they're just two of the most honest, wonderful, well-meaning, warm people, straightforward but warm, that I've ever come across. And yeah, I mean, it sounds, you know, basic, but it truly is the case that this movie's not possible without them.